In this video, I am going to explain anatomy and function of shoulder girdle muscles. Shoulder girdle muscles attach to scapula and spines, plus rib cage. Okay, I will explain one by one. First muscle is this one. You know, this muscle is faded in this picture. This is trapezius. Trapezius, this is huge muscle on backside of body. You can separate trapezius to three parts. This part, and this part, and this part. The yellow part is upper part or upper fiber. Upper fiber, let's say. This part is middle part, middle fiber. Middle fiber. Then, of course, the lower one is lower fiber. Make sense? General function of trapezius is scapular adduction. Adduction is movement that you bring scapula towards thoracic spines. Adduction of scapula. And if you look the function of each fiber, it's going to be a little bit different. Let's see, upper fiber. This guy can do scapular elevation. Elevation plus upward rotation of scapula. Upward rotation is you move scapula this way. This is upward rotation. Upward rotation. Middle fiber is, of course, adduction. It doesn't do a specific movement. And how about lower fiber? This guy can do also upward rotation. And I think lower fiber can do depression. Some anatomy books don't say lower fiber does depression. However, I believe it can do depression. Okay, trapezius, very big and very multifunction muscle. Let's go to next one. Okay, deep to trapezius, there are some shoulder girdle muscles. Let's look this one. This is levator scapula. Levator scapula. What is function of this muscle? You can suggest that. Levator scapula. Elevate. Yep. Elevation. Elevation of scapula. And its orientation is kind of diagonal. It's not completely vertical, right? This diagonal orientation brings scapula to downward rotation. Downward rotation is this movement. Imagine, vector of force is this way. Thus, scapula goes rotation for this way. Very important thing. When trapezius and levator scapula get tight, oftentimes you have tight shoulder around this area. These two muscles are so common for tight shoulder, stiff shoulder. Okay? Next muscle, or next muscle group is these guys. You can separate this muscle to two muscles. In general, they are called rhomboid. Rhomboid. Bigger part is rhomboid major. Smaller part is rhomboid minor. You can call these muscles as rhomboid, or you can separate rhomboid major and rhomboid minor. Function of these two muscles is adduction. Adduction of scapula. And also, they are like diagonal, right? It's diagonal like this way. It's like levator scapula. I said levator scapula can do downward rotation. So does rhomboid. Rhomboid can do downward rotation. Downward rotation. They are so important muscles for scapular movement. By the way, you see this muscle? This muscle can do opposite movement of rhomboid. So this muscle is antagonist of rhomboid. What is this one? Let's look at it. Okay, I changed the picture. This muscle is serratus anterior. Serratus anterior. I said this is antagonist of rhomboid. What is function of rhomboid? That is adduction and downward rotation. So serratus anterior must be able to do opposite movement, right? What is it? That's abduction of scapula. Abduction is you bring scapula outward, okay? Abduction. Plus, this guy can do upward rotation. Upward rotation, which trapezius can do. Upward rotation is this way movement. Serratus anterior can do upward rotation. This muscle attaches to ribcage. That means this muscle is pretty much close to core of body. This muscle oftentimes classified or considered as core muscle of shoulder girdle. Thus, stabilization and mobility of this muscle is crucial for scapular movement. Does it make sense? Very important muscle. What about this one? This is pectoralis minor. Pectoralis minor or pec minor. This is also important for scapular movement. This guy can do depression of scapula. Depression and abduction. And downward rotation. Sorry, it's a little bit hard to see. Pec minor can do depression of scapula, abduction of scapula, and downward rotation. It has so many things to do. This is important for scapular movement and stability. By the way, when serratus anterior and pec minor get tight, that severely inhibit movement of scapula. In result, it's going to be hard to move shoulder joint. Why is that? Because when your scapula doesn't move, you can't move your shoulder. These two bones need to move simultaneously. When scapula is inhibited, shoulder is inhibited as well. Very important relationship. Thus, pec minor and serratus anterior are crucial for shoulder movement. Let's look at last one. Last one is this tiny muscle. This is subclavius. Subclavius. Sub means beneath. So this is below clavicle. This muscle attaches to first rib and clavicle. This muscle can elevate ribcage, let's say elevation. Elevation of ribcage. Same time, this can depress clavicle, so depression. Elevation of ribcage and depression of clavicle. This is tiny muscle, but This is important muscle for myofascial connection of chest, neck, and shoulder. This is important station for myofascial connection. And also, when this muscle gets tight, this can be one cause for tightening up nervous tissues. So this place can be one cause for thoracic outlet syndrome. This tiny muscle can create severe pain for upper limb. Very important. In this video, I explain anatomy of shoulder girdle muscles. They are so important for scapular movement, stabilization, and also for shoulder movement. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.